Hi everyone, as a programmer, you can always utilize your skills by developing tools that can serve the same purpose as other software you need, like in this case, a screen recorder. In this tutorial, we will be using Python to create a screen recorder that can help you accomplish some common basic tasks, just like any other software available out there. We will also be able to add some integrations to our apps, such as the play, pause, and resume functionalities. You can refer to our Hashnode article for a better understanding and a step-by-step guide of the same. I have already created the Tkinter interface using the Proxlight designer. Link to the code and the UI files are given in the description. Here is the code and the image files generated by Proxlight designer. Let's run the code and see how it works. Here is the screen recorder with a polished and vibrant interface. You can rename your recording name like this and set it to any name you want. You can record your screen by clicking on the record button. Let's do some activity. Now, in order to pause or resume the recording, you can use the buttons over here. When you are done, you can stop the recording by clicking on the stop button. After clicking the stop button, your recording will be saved on the current folder where your code is housed. In our case, it is saved as trial.mp4 over here. This video is sponsored by lambdatest.com. It is a browser and app testing cloud for both exploratory and automated testing across 3,000 plus different browsers, real devices, and operating systems. Visit lambdatest by clicking the link given in the description. In order to record the screen, we need a Python library called pyscreenrec. You can install this library on your system by typing pip install pyscreenrec on your terminal. It will take some time to install. Once the download is completed, you can jump right over to VS Code and start coding. This is how the front-end code looks like. The first step is to import pyscreenrec. We will be creating a rec variable where we will be storing the screen recorder function. Let's define functions for record, play, pause, and stop. Under start rec function, we have to create a variable called file where we will be storing the name of the video file which has been entered by the user. We can achieve this by using the get method. To start recording, we will be using start recording method where we will be passing two parameter. The first one is the file name along with its extension. In our case, it will be .mp4. The second parameter is the FPS. You can specify the FPS for the screen recording using the second parameter. It must not be greater than 60. Similarly, let's define other functions. Now under each button, we have to add commands according to their functions. As we have to save the name of the video as per the given input by the user, we have to create a file name variable which will hold string variable method. Under entry widget, we will be getting the text variable as file name. If the user does not enter any name, then by default, we will be giving the default name as untitled recording. This can be achieved by set method. Finally, we have created a screen recorder with multiple functionality. I hope this tutorial was really helpful for you. If it was helpful, then consider subscribing and leave your comments below. I will meet you in another tutorial. Until then, keep coding.